Hey guys, Dagan here from PMTVUK. With a fun little video today, I'm here to answer your most asked Instagram questions. Firstly, if you are already subscribed to PMTVUK, Professional Music Technology, on this here YouTube, first and foremost, thank you very much. It's a lot of fun to do and I'm glad folk get a kick out of as well. But you've got to check out the other social media platforms we have, PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. It's where the fun never stops. I mean, on YouTube, we try and upload as many videos as we can, but on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, that's rocking 24/7. Whether it be any competitions that we're holding, and we do love holding a good old competition, pictures of the lovely gear we've got in our stores, or some hilarious memes to share amongst your friends. They're always on the go, and they're always a lot of fun to follow. It's a great way to get in contact with myself and the PMT guys as well, whether you want information on a guitar, some friendly advice, or let us know that your singer was offended by a meme we shared about how singers don't carry any of the gear into the venue. So, back to why I'm here today. I'm here to answer your questions. I get asked a lot on YouTube comments and on Instagram, certain things, my opinion on certain things, what should you buy, what should you do? So I thought I'd put a story up on Instagram in order to create this video about what do you guys want to know from me? How can I help? And one of the guys at PMT, I haven't seen the questions yet, have compiled a list of lovely questions for me to answer here today. Some of them were kind of similar, so apologies if I haven't answered your question, but I might answer a question within this little list which answers your question. How many times can I say question in this little intro? Anyways, let's get started. The first question, what would you say is the best guitar without being biased? Right. I'm a Gibson guy, I love these guitars, especially SGs. I have a penchant for SGs and anything white and gold to come out of the lovely G factory. But the best guitar, in my opinion, for an overall guitar would probably be something like a HSH Strat, because you can get every kind of sound from said Strat. Strats are very comfy to play, as you can tell by my little video on why they're comfy to play from my 8 facts about the Stratocaster that you probably didn't know. 2 humbuckers. So you get the big thick sounds, and there'll be single coils in the 5-way switch as well. It'll come with a tremolo. Granted, it's not a Floyd Rose double locking tremolo, but you can get trem sounds, humbucker sound, count sounds, single coil sounds, and they're very comfortable to play. I would say something like a HSH Strat. Next up, what is my opinion on the Martin LX1E? I love the Martin LX1E. If you're not sure what the Martin LX1E guitar is, it's the Ed Sheeran guitar. You know the little Martin guitar Ed Sheeran was playing for years? He's had lots of beautiful signature models from it. That one. And I like this guitar for a number of reasons. The first is how portable and awesome it is. It comes with a gig bag, so you can chuck it in the back of the car if you go camping with a family. Take it on a flight if you want to see your aunt and uncle in Denmark. These guitars are great, portable, they sound amazing, and they sound unique. They've got a lovely kind of brightness to them, so they're a great studio tool if you want to add a little bit of poke to your acoustic sound, layer it with some other acoustics. And they're kind of really easy to play because they're a smaller guitar. They're very easy to play. And the fact they've got electrics in the E version, sound awesome. What is more versatile, a Strat or a Tele? I'm gonna go for a Strat solely because there's more pickup selections. There's a 5-way switch as opposed to a 3-way switch, and you have the tremolo, so you can kind of play a bit more on it, if that makes sense. However, they do sound different. So if you're debating the two, I can say as much as I like to you about how versatile a Strat is. You could rock up to a PMT store, pick both up, and fall in love with the sound of the Tele. It might not be as versatile as a Strat, if that makes sense, but you might fall in love with the sound of it, and that's why we play guitar, to fall in love with these beautiful things. Next up's quite fitting. I know you're an SG guy, but do you prefer a Strat or a Tele? I used to have a very nice Telecaster, but I'm a Strat guy, solely because of John Mayer. I love that guy, and that's why I've got a Sunburst Strat. Next up we have, is it better to spend less on the guitar and take some time to do some modifications, or just spend more money on the guitar? I've spent a while thinking about this. That's quite a good question. And it's weird because I personally enjoy messing with guitars. As soon as I get a guitar, I take it a bit again, take it a bit and then put it back together again to see how it works. But I know not a lot of people are like that. People just enjoy the instrument in themselves and are somewhat scared to tinker with it in case they break something. These things are harder than it looks. And unless you pull all the wiring out to break solders, they're not going to break. They're going to be just fine. And the reason people enjoy tinkering with guitars back in the day, say if you're a Van Halen fan or a Keith Richards fan who just wanted a 5-string guitar, or Billy Joe Armstrong from Green Day who has a slanted humbucker in his bluey Strat, is simply because back in the day, there weren't a lot of variants of guitars out there. The reason we have a vast range of different models and shapes and spec guitars these days is because people modded them back in the day, so we haven't got to do it ourselves now. However, personally, I love modding guitars. There's nothing wrong with doing it. It's all personal preference. If you're saying it's in the back of your head to tinker with guitars, you probably buy a guitar that's already been modified to your spec off the shelf, say, and you'll still probably tinker it and tinker with it and have a little play. If the seed's in your mind to mess with the guitars, you will probably mess with the guitars. And you may break more than you fix in the beginning, but you'll get to a stage, like myself, where you actually know what you're doing and you're a competent guitar tech. Number six, what is my opinion on Slipknot overall, and what's your favorite album? I like the album No One Likes, All Hope Is Gone. I love that album. Jim Root is a big guitar inspiration to myself. I'm yet to buy one of his Telecasters, but I really want one of his Telecasters. Earlier stuff's a bit heavy for me, even though there's a few songs on which kind of shaped my childhood. My girlfriend's a huge fan of the early stuff of Slipknot, so I can probably tell you a few songs and play you a few riffs solely through hearing it in the house. But for me, it's All Hope Is Gone. I don't want to get a lot of hate for that, but I love Jim Root and that album. Great riffs, great riffs. What is the one guitar that got away? My one guitar that got away was a Select. I'm going to use this platform to get a guitar back. Well, my one guitar that got away was a Fender Select Series Telecaster in violin sunburst with gold hardware. I swapped it for a Two Rock amplifier a few years ago and regretted it ever since. So if one of you guys out there is selling a Fender Select Series USA Telecaster in violin burst with gold hardware, I've even got the serial number if you want to check the serial number, let me know and I want it back. How do you know what notes to play in an improvised solo? Is it just a feel kind of thing? By the way, love the vids. Well, thank you first off for enjoying the vids. I enjoy making them. I'm glad you enjoy watching them. When it comes to improvising a solo, I wish I had more guitar lessons as a kid. So if you're watching this starting out, get guitar lessons simply just to learn scales and where things work on the neck. The only way I know how to play Where to Go is because I've been playing guitar for so long. Everything I play is in E and A pretty much, and I know what scales and shapes work over that. I probably can't name the scales for you, but I know how they work. So if you start guitar out there, get some lessons and improvise as much as you can. YouTube is key. Listen to some backing tracks on YouTube and practice along. When you're in your house by yourself, no one's going to point at you and say it's the wrong note. Learn as many different key solos as you can just by playing along with backing tracks. And when it comes to playing with real musicians, they'll say this is in B, you'll know exactly where to go on the fretboard. See, this is fun. This, get yourself to the PMT House of Rock Instagram page, and I might do this again. You can ask me some questions, and you might get on this lovely little video on the next time round. Or Facebook for that matter. Just check them all out. It's a lot of fun. Next up, Dream Festival lineup, dead or alive? Well, my favorite bands are AC/DC, the Sex Pistols, and Queen. So probably an amalgamation of them. Maybe make it a really avant-garde festival and throw Prince in there. Love Prince, bit of Motorhead, Avenged Sevenfold, Pantera. I'm probably missing loads out, all the good guys of that kind of thing. If I do think of one after this, I'll probably put it on the side somewhere. Most underrated guitar slash band. That could mean guitarist slash band. Most underrated guitar, I think, from literally working in a music store, are the new East Coasts that are available for like £99. I wish I had those guitars when I was starting out. Like, the play and feel, like they're a lot higher value than what they actually are. They're great, and there's so many different styles like Strats and Les Pauls and all that kind of stuff. Underrated guitarist has to be Mick Mars from Motley Crue. Motley Crue, one of my favorite bands of all time. Actually, I should have put that in the festival one as well. Yeah, that probably pinged up at the side, didn't it? And most underrated band. I don't know what to say for underrated band, because a lot of the bands I like are rated pretty highly, or they were underrated and now they're back at fruition. I'll probably say something like LA Guns. The band that came together with Hollywood Rose to form Guns N' Roses. I'm pleased to say that I know Mr. Tracy Guns quite well. He's an awesome dude, the guy who put the Guns in Guns N' Roses. And they were kind of not put on the back foot because Guns N' Roses got so big, but they've got some amazing tunes. They've just released a new album and a new tune, and it's absolutely kick-ass. Check out No Mercy and Malaria and loads of great LA Guns songs. I'm going to say LA Guns. Favorite guitarist from a Manchester-based band? I'm going to have to say someone like Noel Gallagher, because I'm not the hugest Oasis fan in the world, but I play Oasis songs quite a lot to live weddings and corporate events and all the kind of stuff I do in my band, The Reissues. And those songs are really catchy. They're fun to play. They're not the hardest things in the world to play, but they're fun and everyone knows them. They're iconic kind of chord progressions and riffs. So I'm going to say big Noel. Hey Dagan, I've been looking at a new humbucker guitar to start saving up to. PRS SE, Gibson SG Faded, or Les Paul Tribute. Thanks, man. Every part of me wants to say Gibson's like the Les Paul Tribute, because Les Pauls are amazing and my favorite guitar is the SG. But the PRS SE's in there, and that is one hell of a versatile guitar. You know, earlier I mentioned that HSH Strats are probably my most versatile thing in my head. They're not too dissimilar to the PRS SE range, two humbuckers which you can coil split so you can get every conceivable pickup tone from it, and they've got a vibrato bar. PRS are the perfect cross-pollination of Gibson and Fender if you're not too sure which one to go for. They've got all the amenities of like humbuckers from a Gibson and whammy bars and stuff, but they're the scale length of a Fender and they've got 24 frets, so it's everything all in one, so I'm gonna say PRS. Never stop being awesome. I will try to never stop being awesome, but sometimes I feel like I'm trying too hard because I'm literally in an empty room with two cameras right now, chatting away to myself. So if this is classed as awesome, then so be it. I'm thinking of picking up the Boss Katana Mark II 100 watt and wanted to ask if you'd recommend it. I'm an advanced beginner and play at home, don't gig. Also, what are your thoughts on the Player Series Fender Telecaster? Let me know your thoughts. Thanks. Well, first off, the Boss Katana came on the scene and blew everyone's mind because it does everything really well and it's not a lot of money. The Mark II came on the scene and kind of changed that with adding certain, well, opening up the sounds a bit more and changing the effect parameters you can tinker with. For home, the 100 watt's pretty big, but if you want to rock the 100 watt home, dudes, totally rock the 100 watt, because if you do want a gig in the future, you've got a 100 watt amp to play with, and they do sound great no matter what volume they are because of the power soak you can do with it, so totally rock the 100 watt. If you're thinking the 100 watt over the 50, hell yeah, do the 100 watt. It's bigger, and we're guitarists. We like big amps and stuff because it makes us think differently. Also, Player Series Telecasters are amazing. I think I've got a video somewhere on the Player Series Telecaster. The best guitars to come out with the Mexican Fender plant in a lot of years, and they've always been good, so you know they're going to be very good. What is the best budget Les Paul with a slim neck? Depends what you mean here, because Les Paul could be just that classic single cut shape, or actually an Epiphone or a Gibson. For a slimmer necked budget Les Paul, I would say something like the East Coast guitars. Not a lot of money, but they have got a little bit of a slimmer neck to accommodate every kind of player. Then when you go to the Epiphones, the 60s inspired ones have a thinner neck than the 50s inspired ones, and it's the same up from there. Kind of Gibson do a lot of slim taper necks. 60s necks are quite small. When you see like the modern C's and the 50s spec necks, then you're looking at a big chunker. Next up, can we see a cover video of the song Joker and the Thief? See, there's a lot of random ones in here, as well as very informative ones. You might mean by my band, The Reissues, because we put some cover videos online. And I'm not going to do it in this video because copyright will have my backside. I'm just getting the one-handed version there, but you might get it on The Reissues page soon. Next up, it's a good one. What is the best way to increase dexterity, speed, and accuracy with both my fretting hand and picking hand? Love your vids. Again, first off, thank you for enjoying these videos. But I have some bad news for you. There's no way to get good at it quickly. The best way to improve speed and accuracy is to literally just sit or stand and just give it the old chromatics up the strings. Going down the way, then descending from the little pattern you've got going on, the chromatic pattern, all the way up the neck as many times as you want until your hands get sore. Your picking hand gets sore and your fretting hand gets sore. But that's the same as literally working out. Like, that was weird. Doing this in a gym. Your arm muscles get sore and then they rebuild and then they stop being sore. The soreness is the breakdown of muscle and stuff and then they rebuild up again and stronger than what they were before. And it's the same with your fingers. When it comes to right hand, playing stuff like rad Metallica riffs and learning triplets and trying to get solid with the triplets, but always practice to a metronome, not even like an old school wooden one. You can get metronomes on your phones these days that are great. So always practice with the metronome, start slow and then build up speed. What are some affordable SGs with great playability intending on replacing electronics, bridge and tuners? Right, with that, what I was saying earlier about messing with guitars, do that if you want. If you can't find a guitar on the shelf that's what you want, do that. But it's not like guitars were a while ago. You can buy a cheap Epiphone these days and the electronics will outlast a guitar built 10 years ago. They're absolutely fantastic. Some of the quality stuff, the Epiphone SG G400s, the inspired by Gibsons are even better. And again, if you want more of a budget, give PMT a call, call into your local store and see if you've got any tasty secondhand ones available. We're the biggest UK retailer, so we've got lots of lovely secondhand stuff about. Or send us a message on Instagram and Facebook, like I was saying before. We can check stuff anywhere for you. Are PMT selling the Kramer Beretta Special? What color would you have? Purple. To put it simply, yes and yes, we are selling the Kramer Beretta Special. Give PMT a call or even a message on Instagram and Facebook. And I would have it in purple because it's a Kramer and Kramer is one of my all-time favorite brands. Of course I'll have it in a crazy 80s purple color. Coming to the end now, what's the best guitar I've ever played? Best guitar I've ever played is either this Les Paul Custom or my SG Custom. Again, I'm an SG guy. Guitar playing is very much in your head, and when I was a kid, I always wanted these guitars. Saved up for many, many years, ate Rye Vitas for many, many months on end, and cornflakes, and finally could afford these amazing guitars. So these are my favorite. The best guitar in sense of fanciness, a 52 No Caster from Fender, original vintage one, which played like bins. Which a lot of old guitars do. You don't realize, old guitars are old guitars, and they're kind of, some of them are really sucky to play. You've got to give them a refret and give a bit of a revamp to make them play like modern guitars that we're used to. However, that totally destroys the value, and it's a bit of a curse with that one. Or a 52 Les Paul Gold Top with the trapeze bridge, which is also one of my favorite guitars. That one was very nice. Best modeling amps for under £500 is the new Fender Mustang GTX. Worth it. The Fender Mustang GTXs are some of the best sounding modeling amps on the planet right now. You can do so much with it, and the fact that you can tweak things Bluetooth through your phone and play music through is such a 21st century quirk. It's amazing, and the sound quality, even just playing music through it, is amazing. Check out the Marshall Origin as well. Not Marshall Origin, Marshall Code as well. They kind of do two different things. All the new Line 6 Spider 5s. The new Line 6 Spider stuff is amazing. I have a Line 6 Spider 5 in my living room that I jam with. They're all great. They all do slightly different things though. They all do the same thing really well, but all slightly different tones. So call into your local PMT store and try them out. Best thing I can recommend. Hi Dagan, I'm looking for an electric guitar for around £100 to £150 to take to university with me to practice. I like listening to Nirvana, Foo Fighters, and Deep Purple. First off, great choice of bands. Secondly, I think I mentioned East Coast a few times in this video. Check out East Coast guitars, they're fantastic. They look great, they play great, and they're not a lot of money. If you want something with more of a brand name on top, check out the Squire Affinities and the Squire Bullets. It's Can't Go Wrong with Squire, the Geo range from Ibanez, some fantastic guitars. Jackson do the GK22s as well. A bit more pointy when it comes to playing Deep Purple stuff, you can get a bit more old school heavy metal on, even though Blackmore used the Strat. Check out some Epiphones as well, Epiphone Les Paul Specials and all that malarkey, PRS SE Standards. The list's endless, and that's why you've got to come into a PMT store and try them for yourself. You can read as much as you want online and hear me chatting away on YouTube till the day is long. But you've got to rock up to one of our stores. With so many guitars available that are all great these days, it's a very personal thing playing these amazing little instruments. And we're literally here to help you along the way. We're here to talk, listen to you and find out what your favorite bands are, then find a few guitars that'll suit that. You might fall in love with something which you didn't intend to fall in love with, and that's the fun of music and guitars. So there we have it, ladies and gents, me answering some of your lovely questions from Instagram. Again, if you want to be in the second part of this video, if this one does well, get yourself to PMT House of Rock on Instagram, and we might do some more questions in a bit. Or if you just want to ask some random questions about guitars, basses, you want some advice, or again, you've upset someone by sharing a meme and now your drummer and bass player are upset. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on any of the guitars I've spoke about here today, get yourself to pmtonline.co.uk, or like I kept harping on about, get yourself to a PMT store and try them out. PMT House of Rock, all social media. I've been Dagan, I'll see you next time.